खास महेंद्रने इन्व्हाइट करून नाशिकला हा प्लांट चालू करायला सांगितलं. काय होतं माझं नाशिकचे तर त्याची एस यू वी गाडी पण खूप पोकलो होतं. 300
कॉम्प्लिमेंट्स दॅट यू हॅव बिकम द कलेक्टर ऑफ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डायनॅमिक डिस्ट्रिक्ट इन द स्टेट. So, Nashik is regarded always, Nashik is always regarded as one of the finest and very, very nice districts in the state. And after joining here, immediately I myself experienced that, why the district has got such a good reputation. Because you see, elections were on at that time when I took over the charge. And few rounds had already happened, so the cities which recorded very less voting, those were told on net and all that the participation in democracy is very less, and also a few citizens from Nashik came to me with a proposal, not with a complaint. That was a very big surprise during my 25 years of administrative career, that mostly people reached the administration with the list of complaints, but they came up with a proposal that we don't like our city to get trolled like this, so we must do something so that our city will record good percentage of voting. So I immediately joined hand with them and we undertook one campaign. It was called Vote Kar Nashikkar, that everybody joined hands, all industries, everybody joined hands, all associations. And to my surprise, in the election we recorded the highest percentage, highest of the 52 years. So then they again came to thank me, but I said this thank is not for me, rather I would say ki I thank you, because it was this, as if the definition of democracy goes, of the people, by the people, for the people. So it was by the Nashikkar, for the Nashikkar, of the Nashikkar type of campaign, and that left a very good mark in my on my heart. And then I started saying that I am Ashik of Nashik. So I think that the people who have come from outside will soon also become Ashik of Nashik, because as you see, we supply 1/3 of the wine consumed in the country. That's for the evening thing, not in the daytime. But every third bottle consumed in India is manufactured in Nashik. Every third onion consumed in India is manufactured in Nashik. We have got a platter of everything, great tourism potential. Right from trekking to religion to everything, the host of Kumbh Mela also. So this city, this district has got a multifarious face, and everything is here. The platter is so huge that you will like some or other aspect of it. So that is the great potential of Nashik. So I think on livability index also, this is one of the finest cities. If you see the atmospheric clarity, the livability standard, the cost of life here, all everything is quite moderate as compared to if you go just 100 kilometers away from here, the cost of living gets doubled towards Mumbai. Towards Pune, the livability standard goes down. So this is a correct mixed platter of everything, good livability at moderate cost. So I wonder why it is not flourishing like other cities. But then I again realize that the citizenry here, the people here who are the major players here, they don't want this city to get into the, what you say, developed mess. So that is a decided, that is a conscious decision not to grow beyond a point. That also I liked very much, because you see, the development comes with some riders. It is not that everything is free of cost. You have to pay the cost of livability, then transport system get into mess, then your solid waste management goes haywire. So this is a conscious decision not to grow beyond a point. So growing potential is huge, but they are controlling it, and that is also a good sign. So this is also a very unique thing, which I think only few districts have got this type of watchful citizenry, watchful associations. And now slowly the thinking is changing, that instead of not allowing people to come in, instead of controlling the whole growth, why not to have a very selective growth? And that's why such type of business meets are very essential. When the like-minded people meet, they decide a strategy, they can decide the window, how much to be opened, and then certain industries can come in. So I extend my best wishes to all of you, in that it is a very nice beginning. Only thing which I shared with these people that the event is not an end in itself. Event is a medium to get something ahead. So let us not lose the sight of our destination. Let us not enjoy the journey. Because you see, the seminars, the pamphlet making and advertisement and everything, these are all, this is the journey. Where it is leading, it is going to the destination that some industry must come here, some good industries must come here. They should also get benefited out of our expertise, because you see, we have got a great legacy of industry and great legacy of culture. Everything is really very, very adorable. So they should also take benefit of it, and we should also get benefit of it. So it should be win-win situation for both, and for good application of mind is required. So such seminars should be targeted towards that end, not an end in itself. So I feel the dais is set at a right thing. If everybody is aware that what is our destination and how to go towards that. So from the administrative side, I will say this is my target, to break the stereotypes. You see, when the Britishers ruled us for 150 years or more than that, they have divided us into society and government. So we have got a typical mindset that we expect that government should do everything. Means I always give one example that when the water enters into your home, four good looking adults just stand there and they wait for our talati to come. They say, how will we leave? Who will take out water from our home? From our home, how will we four persons live here then? That's their question. They wait the talati to come. They don't think that they should take the bucket and put the water out. They say, how we four fully grown adults will live in this home till the talati comes. That is just a symbolic thing I am telling. So in the last Zoom meeting also I raised that point that we should think that the potential, the problem is there and potential is also there. So you will have to think about that. Don't wait that someone else will come, some miracle will happen. So we will have to solve our problems also. And as you say, a commoner will see a problem, but entrepreneur will see it as an opportunity. As long as there are problems, there is chance to solve the problem and there is chance to do some business out of that problem. So I think that this should be the mindset that we are here to solve the problem and convert that problem into a business opportunity and become a good businessman. And so from administrative side, whatever is required, I'll be there all the time. So you can take it for granted that wherever my presence is required, whatever my interventions are required, wherever my personal attention is required, you please feel free to get in touch with me. And as our Honorable Prime Minister, our Honorable Chief Minister have also set the stage like this, ease of doing business, we have jumped almost 100 positions ahead during the last 1 or 2 years. Many problems have already been sorted out, but some minor problems may be there, some implementation issues may be there. But we are here to help you, we are here to help you grow. We are here to make your journey quite better and enjoyable. So we will tie hand with each other and we will develop some good synergy. So Nashik will see the great progress in the industry and even in the living standard of the city. So I extend my best wishes to you. I thank you for calling me here and introducing me with many people with whom we are expecting that it will be a very long-standing association ahead also. So thank you so much and all the best to you.